Meet Zarganar, Burma's most famous comedian. For more than 25 years, he's been using political satire to highlight the oppression that's been happening in his country. Burma has been under military rule since 1962. It's one of the most repressive regimes in the world, with consistent reports from the UN of human rights violations. Zarganar dared to speak out against his government and was subsequently banned from talking to the media. But he didn't let this intimidate him.
Our country's people, our Burmese people, they have many feelings in their deep of heart. There are many feelings, they have many words in their bottom of heart, but they're afraid of. They don't dare to criticize, they don't dare to speak aloud. So I am their loudspeaker.
In 2008, Zarganar was arrested yet again for speaking out against the government's brutality through his comedy and to overseas media. He was sentenced to 35 years in prison. English filmmaker Rex Bloomstein, who had interviewed Zarganar in 2007, decided to produce the feature-length documentary This Prison Where I Live. It's been shown all around the world through Amnesty International.
So it means if you fear, that fear will be exerted by the Zarganar. This is our Burmese traditional words. So I took that name for me. My name is Zarganar.
Last month, this film was previewed in Wellington, the political hub of New Zealand, by Victoria University's Amnesty International Group.
Politics-wise, it's a kind of a no-brainer for New Zealanders because, it's pretty much a costless exercise to call for democracy in Myanmar, and only good can come of it, really.
The importance of political satire is something Wellington-based comedian Raybon Khan knows all about.
Just so you know, the reason I'm here is because I'm probably the closest thing to a Burmese comedian they could find.
He was asked to open the event to show support for his fellow comedian and highlight the importance of a comedian's right to the freedom of expression.
To me, it's just one of those things that you almost don't think about. If comedy has a role, it's sort of to speak up against power. I think that's, you know, it should be speaking up for change.
The people cry, we cry. People laugh, we laugh. People hate, we hate. It's that. So we must stand in front of the people.
Reflect the people.
Yeah. And we must sacrifice for the people.
As a comedian, you just take it for granted that you can say whatever, with the right to offend as many people as are in the room. That's the situation we're in. We're on the frontier of freedom of expression, you know. It just makes no sense to have rules around it. So it's mind-boggling to consider a different situation. The least you can do when they're in such an extreme situation is at least draw our attention to it.
This extreme oppression is something Wellington-based resident Nang Koko knows all about. He himself was a political prisoner in Burma, imprisoned for 7 years for taking part in a protest as a student.
Actually, I was arrested on 6th December 1992, and I was arranging with our student to call the democracy and human rights just for putting the leaflet around the Rangoon. It was our crime. During the interrogation, I didn't know whether day or night. My eyes are pulled down and put it in my head. And also, they interrogate me for nearly 1 month. Within that time, I didn't know whether day or night. And they give me only 1 teaspoon of water a day. They didn't give me any food.
Despite being released from prison and accepted into New Zealand as a refugee 5 years ago, Nang Koko can't forget those who are still locked away. He's been working tirelessly to promote this event.
I have moral responsibility because I was being as a political prisoner. There are 2,220 political prisoners who are behind. So by highlighting the Zarganar, the Kiwi and the New Zealander will know about the political prisoner of Burma in here.
And along with informing people about Zarganar's situation, tonight this group will be giving people a chance to take action by signing postcards as a petition that will be sent to the Burmese government.
If the people, more and more people, are sending the letter and signature, it could be huge effect on the people who are in the behavior. They thought that they are forgotten political prisoner. No one knows who they are. They might feel that. But when you send the letter via the post office or internet, or the regime might know that some people from 8,000 miles far away from New Zealand are still recognized that they are encouraged about freedom in Burma. And that's the main key point we are requesting for. Please use your liberty to liberate us.
Zarganar's current situation is certainly no laughing matter. Recent reports say he's battling a number of health issues and was denied hospital treatment for 10 days after collapsing. This group hopes tonight's event will make a difference. Hundreds of postcards have been signed and many more people are aware and passionate about Zarganar's cause.
It was incredibly moving and distressing that someone that was such a ray of light, that was so inspiring to a nation, is locked away for 35 years. It made me very angry and very sad.
So where do you get your courage from?
Courage. I think, sir, I think this is not a courage, this is an ordinary people's spirit, I think.
That man's spirit will live on for 100 years. It would seem the difference between democracy and dictatorship is laughter, the power of laughter. And that military regime in Burma are bullies and cowards, and they're very afraid. They're scared of the power of laughter.
Do you think your jokes have the power to change things?
To change things? So, actually, I don't think so. But they ignite the brain of the people, and when they got the light, they will try to change.
So you've survived prison.
Yeah.
You can survive anything.
Yes, this is the beauty of survival.
If you missed this event but want to help, it's not too late. You can visit the Amnesty website and sign a postcard online and help make a difference to this courageous man and the thousands of others like him in Burma. Hey.